Valentin asked Aligas, if you were going to submit Pacio, what do you think you'd catch him with? And he said, rear naked. Inside closed guard here, trying to pop the head on. He does so. Aligas, free of any danger right now.
Time.
Yeah, right there. As he was trying to get his hands out, he had his fingers in the eye of Joshua Pacio. The referee timeout. Looks like there possibly could have been a headbutt. Maybe an eye poke when he was trying to get his hands or trying to get free from the guillotine. We're going to show that again in a replay, but I think he had his hands on his face and he was trying to pry his head out of the guillotine.
Yellow card being issued there, Jack. Beautiful.
Yeah, that kicking reach floats around the outside of the cage.
Looks to control this. Pacio to the outside. Pacio suits in. Nice score there from Deligas. Defensive takedown. It's a trip reversal here. Deligas looks for top position dragon.
Deligas does a beautiful job controlling that underhook of Pacio and using that wizard to get him over on top. Now, Pacio's got double underhooks. This is where Team Lakai really excels in the takedowns. Trying to control the posture of Pacio. Pacio's in a good spot, but big bridge.
Pacio said he'd submit him with an armbar or a rear naked choke. Valentin asked Deligas, if you were going to submit Pacio, what do you think you'd catch him with? And he said, rear naked. Inside closed guard here, trying to pop the head on. He does so. Deligas, free of any danger right now.
Time.
We're going to actually restart him back in the guillotine position with his head trapped under his arm.
And Deligas has the head free. The hammer fist strike off the right hand. Elbows to the clavicle there from Pacio. 1 minute 40 remains.
On the right side of Deligas, possibly looking to sweep him over. But yeah, there's the kimura, fully locked in. And use it.
He's defended.
Good point.
Knee bar or rear naked choke was a prediction from Pacio. Deligas now top position, back inside the guard of Pacio. We are seeing truly a seesawing contest on the ground for Joshua Pacio.
Again, hunting for that kimura on that right side. He's going to use the same thing. It's deja vu, the same moves keep happening. Look for Deligas to bridge out of this.
Ground and pound now, as Pacio postures up, Deligas tries to throw the legs up. Pacio doing some damage. Elbows now to the forehead from Joshua Pacio. These will score well for the young gun. Deligas nowhere to go. Final seconds of the opening round. Dominance here from Joshua Pacio. Mount position. Deligas almost gives his back.
One too many times.
And his hands off here.
Up to the body.
Pacio on the outside. Have that one punch. Precision. So too, Pacio. And it's the no way. What a knockout. Joshua Pacio.
16.
Tonight, another epic episode.
Another shot at the belt.
Blocked by Pacio. Close down the distance and speed of Pacio. Big kick again there from Amnoy Sirichok. Mitch explained there.
To slowly start to watch. He's got the juice to go all three rounds.
Try to pull Pacio down, break his posture, and hand fight a bit, Mitch.
Just kind of holding him there.
Watching very carefully here.
Pacio's going to pop his head out like he just did and really just see how he's just softening up the body. But I like how Amnoy Sirichok's throwing elbows from the bottom.
Perhaps force a stand-up.
Showing the top position. Doing a lot of damage. Shouting out instructors.
Pacio looking to finish here. Few seconds left in the round. And the fans cheering.
No setup whatsoever.
Not as much power, Mitch.
If Pacio, yep, caught a kick.
Mitch, that's efficient.
There's a lot of time for Pacio to start working. Do a lot of damage. And the story of the fight so far.
From our angle here on the monitor, there we go, much better. Possible straight armbar here.
Yeah, he's got the straight armbar, but he might transition into a kimura where Amnoy Sirichok seems to be keeping the arm straight. It's going to be very hard to submit at that position.
Finish.
I could be wrong in saying that he's not trying to create scrambles.
Pacio now trying to force his way into mount, but great defense there from Amnoy Sirichok. Amnoy Sirichok trying to explode. Pacio thinking about the back take here and goes with the body lock.
Attempt to get back up to his feet. He might get suplexed here, but let's use just the hands and see if we can change.
Again, a lot of pressure by Omnoy Sirichoke, thinking about the takedown.
Yeah, that's what he wants. He's going just after Pacio, though. Yes, that Pacio has.
Surging in confidence is Omnoy Sirichoke. Wow.
Right back after it again, just that constant chain wrestling, going for takedown after takedown. Omnoy Sirichoke.
As he goes off the left hand on the edge of their seat here at the Impact Arena, able to keep his hips away over the midway point.
Fading a little bit as Dez starts to body, goes to the head.
Omnoy Sirichoke as he continues to waltz forward. Pacio looks tough.
They're giving the crowd exactly what they want. Thailand striking battle.
Continues to plod onwards. Out comes the mouthpiece from Pacio. Pacio looks rough.
Lupini, world champion, shoots it for the takedown. Starts the hammer. It's important to know we are judging the fight on its entirety.
Man, much aggression.
Stalking after the Filipino. This is very close. Seconds left. Landing strikes. Dez just is moving forward.
Finish line as Omnoy Sirichoke. 10 seconds.
Damn, that could have been the punctuation mark he needed.
There's not a lot of time. Oh, big one there! Veteran mind game moves as Pacio.
Champions of the market. Bring the guys from the champion to here. Time they confounded Pacio. Oh, the hand right. Vegas moves a little more comfortable. Left to I can finish the job around with the knockdown. That big breath. That's the low leg kicks. Saruta.
Nice.
Saruta outside leg kick. Baguio City.
A bit confused here in the second. By Saruta, does not stay still. He ducks under a big head kick there. Saw it coming.
Just tucked under the left arm. Body shot stuck. Moving here from right there.
Biggest punch to the ball happened in the first. There's Saruta mixing things in with the takedowns. Skip the takedown. Now he's trying to pass the guard. Nice elevation there.
It's a counter. Yeah, look, a punch here.
Scoring in the mind.
Overall battle. High kick again. A little bit more action for
I did, sir. Ends up in half guard.
Pacio on the canvas, and he's back there.
Tight to get his grip back about it. This is where Saruta's got to create a little bit of space and start pushing the head down. There he goes. Good scramble by Joshua.
From Pacio. Let's see for a similar kick by Saruta. Get up and go.
Straight right pan.
Oh, high kick to a spinning back fist to a left hand. What a combination from Pacio.
Big difference in style. The strike at Pacio, the grappler Silva. Now Silva top position.
could be stuck in the guillotine here. This may be Pacio's chance to sub Alex Silva. And Silva's safe. He's seen it all before. Top position now for the Little Rock.
Yeah, so the space. He's able to end this match on top. Nice little attempt at a leg block.
High kick from Pacio. Silva locks onto a single leg. Pacio not going to ground. And now puts Silva on his back.
Look at the way Silva's trying, chasing those legs, hunting after a leg lock out, just to kind of control the overhooks, control the head posture. You can see the way Silva's trying to shove his head underneath the armpit. He's possibly looking for an arm triangle choke, but he's got to get past the legs of Joshua Pacio.
Feet on hips here from Silva. Now Pacio back to his feet. And there it is, an attempt from Pacio. Top position here for Alex Silva, Dragon.
So they drilled it over and over, making sure Pacio could maintain his guard and stay out of danger. And even when Silva does able, you know, to work his way past the guard or the half guard, now he's in a triangle position. Pacio chooses to let it go. Silva's trying to step over the legs into half guard. It's applied even more in full mount. Here comes the squeeze.
Alex Silva now applies the pressure to Joshua Pacio. Alex Silva. Pacio defending.
Oh, good work by Joshua Pacio to get out of that.
Silva, who defended the title last time in an all-Filipino affair against Rene Catalan, beat him in the second round by arm triangle choke. And looks like Pacio will get out of the second round. Both have produced a multitude of world champions across all divisions.
And that's you know, the unconventional ways to get it to the ground. Now he's got that butterfly hook on that side, so he's going to try to elevate it. Might be looking for the legs again. Good job by Pacio.
Punch combination from the Brazilian. Sprawl there from Pacio.
Younger that Pacio is, that's only going to play to his favor as the match goes on.
It's the liver of Alex Silva. Switching stances, Silva drops down, looking for a takedown, but it's Pacio in top position.
He's got so much mat time in his life. He's so dangerous, especially off his back. But that sweat, you can see Joshua Pacio was able to pull out because the legs are slippery now.
To his feet for Pacio and the boss, Olivia. A beautiful combination. Now a double leg and now a single leg from Silva. And Pacio defending. Silva wants the Filipino, the world champion, on his back.
Look at Alex Silva, he's trying to float over, but a good job by Pacio to maintain that guard. But look at that reversal. Now Joshua Pacio's on top. Alex Silva does a nice little hip escape to retain half guard. Nice little elevator sweep there.
How's it get the full mount on Pacio? Jumping knee! And a takedown from Silva. Wiley, a veteran, as Mitch said earlier, he's been here since one champ.
So far, to see how things have played out in the first four rounds. And now we're approaching the fifth round. It could come down to this.
You know, on his one championship debut back in 2012, at one championship number two, Alex Silva was beaten 15 paces. Single leg lock on here from Silva, hunting for a takedown. Hopscotch time for Joshua Pacio. Still can't get him down, now he does. Top position, half guard for Alex Silva. Looking for the ground and pound, Silva. Postures up now, the Brazilian. Gets elevated by Pacio momentarily. 30 seconds to go.
Right, see that left hand of Pacio is underneath it, cradling that arm there, so he can use the right hand to try to get underneath the chin. It's close. Might be a little bit too high. He needs to settle down a little bit lower.
Mitsutsu is undefeated, 9-0. He may be staring down the barrel of his first ever loss.
Oh, look what Joshua Pacio.
He is! Here it is, Mitch.
Take a look at this. Oh, it's not doing, the angle is not doing it justice. Look at this, how he has the arm, and then he cranks it completely back.
Oh, pay it, Mitch, rear naked chicken wing.
Maybe we could call it a reverse Kimura. I don't know what that was, but look at that. His arm, his hand almost touched the back of his head.
No chance he is to wish him on the ground.
He only has one submission win in 8 victories, and look at this!
Oh, that was beautiful as he slid into the heel hook. You can see Pacio's trying to attack a toe lock. Looks like he might want to abandon that idea. Actually defending kind of well with that leg. He's not enabling the leg to get put into position. Now Kakaron's rolling into it. He's got to put a foot on the butt.
Take the heel home of Joshua Pacio. Pacio has 7 stops in 14 wins and 5 knockouts.
But that's just how fast the game. You see how fast he went for that heel hook? That was beautiful.
And here's Pacio's turn. Remember, Pacio came out in the media and said he could finish Rene Catalan in under 15 minutes.
He's got to get out of this knee bar attempt here right now. You can see Catalan is getting going after these leg locks. That's a knee bar right there. That's a bit uncomfortable.
A chant goes up inside the Mall of Asia Arena. It's a divided chant. This crowd is split down the center. Half of them for Rene Catalan, half of them for Joshua Pacio. This all-Filipino affair.
Rene's getting a long blue choke. Good job to get back in the half guard, but he beats that headlock like that. You see Pacio being driving his shoulder to the neck.
That's it.
Top position for the champion in the red.
You can see how he's grinding his head. But it's kind of there for him. Now he's going into mount. The head is still there. If he can pass the other leg over, he might have an arm triangle.
It was a time not long ago.
Yep, there it is. Let's see if he steps over. Now he's in full mount. Not quite set up correctly, but if he swings over to the other side, oh, he can do it in full mount. Now he's got it locked in.
Now
that's
turn.
A bad spot.
Is this the time for Pacio to take the win? Catalan's in trouble. Catalan's in big trouble.
Pacio's got a good squeeze. He's got a good squeeze here.
The grimace on the face is about to tap out.
Got a wrap.
Is he about to tap out? He is.